actually look at that red square in the centre of the diagram, actually it sort of seems to bolster right next to another building anyway, so there's been no objection. So
fine.
Based on the fact that it's a conservatory, you would like to propose that there's no objections by the Town Council. Proposed by Paul, seconded by Nick. All those in favour? So Town Council have got no objections to this application. I'm still a bit confused because I thought a lot of these conservatory things now would not need to come, but... the second one then is... this might be more interesting. This is the conversion, change of use and conversion into flats, isn't it? Mm. The Three Crowns.
Yeah,
yeah. This is on the Oakham...
Billy.
Yeah, Steaming Billy. Oakham North East Ward. It is in a conservation area. And has anybody got any comments about this?
It's a difficult one because I quite sad to see a pub going, another one. But then they did lose a fish and chip shop down the end of Finkie Street. Times change, we've lost the hairdressers.
Yes.
But if they can't sell it as a pub, then I can't see any grounds for it not being converted. Nobody's actually coming to me, or I haven't seen anything of anybody saying campaign to keep it.
There's been, on the website, the objections state, the Three Crowns is a traditional pub located on the diverse street of Northgate within the conservation area and within Oakham Town Centre. The Three Crowns is of value for the following main reasons. So whoever's put these on has obviously read planning regulations.
It wasn't there when I looked.
One, community value. It is felt that the Three Crowns offers a place where people of all groups can meet and interact and therefore enhances the social well-being, which is a key player in the community, of the community located in the town centre. It is highly accessible to the whole community, certainly the town centre community. Two, economy. Northgate is a mixed and diverse street consisting of housing, independent business and retailers and other uses. Three Crowns support the local economy through providing jobs and in particular plays an important contribution to the unique and distinctive economy of Northgate.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, brilliant. And third reason, the Three Crowns is a historic building located within the conservation area. The building with its traditional pub signage forms a highly visible landmark on Northgate. The Three Crowns contribute significantly to the character and local distinctiveness of the conservation area. Now, these have been submitted by various people. Not all of them live in Oakham. Camera, the campaign for Real Ales, they're partly behind these objections. So it was Camera and two other people. Five neighbours have been consulted in the immediate area. The neighbour right next door to the premises has actually replied back and said, I've got no objection.
No.
And none of the other neighbours have replied back. Highways at Rutland County Council have said there's no objection, because one of the planning considerations that could be an objection is where it impacts on parking.
Yeah.
However, the Highways have said no objections as the parking standards for the three units is below the standards required for the public living quarters. If put a note to the applicant, it would be worthwhile thinking about the two-space parking arrangements. Tandem parking may not be appropriate in the location if the two spaces are dedicated to different households. The question mark is, I think you just said it, Martin, that if the business can't be working as a going concern as a local pub, and in actual fact, it's called the Steaming Billy, it was called something, it was called the Griffin, wasn't it, before?
Yeah.
It's changed name a couple of times.
The man who owns it, I don't want to say too much in public, but he has tried very hard. I know him, and not as a friend, just know who he is, and he has tried very hard to make it a going concern. But people aren't using it.
No.
And I know what cameras say, and they're keen to keep pubs, but if people are not using it, the man runs very successful other pubs in the Steaming Billy group. He wouldn't sell it because he actually bought that pub. His connection was originally, he was part of the grain store. He's a local man.
Right, okay.
And he bought that pub with the intention of keeping it as a pub, but obviously it's...
What is it?
There are facilities at either end, effectively.
Well, you've got the Merry Monk, which is used completely. Round the corner, you've got the Railway Inn.
Yeah. Which is very well used now. They've got the music. I went past the other
Whereas I sort of seen the objections, the fact that the neighbours haven't complained, and neither have the highways, and it is a very congested street, if they've got no objections. I do, and to a certain extent, I mean, material planning considerations, one of those is that noise or disturbance is one of the reasons for refusing. So if it then was left as a pub, or became a degenerated pub, or was not even vacated, or was vacated and not occupied and then falls into a state of disrepair, then it brings down the whole of the area. So I personally have got no objections that this planning application or this change of use and work goes ahead. So anybody else would care to propose that? Or well,
you can propose.
I'll propose that there's no objections from the town council based on... we've seen the objections, looked at them, but I don't think they're strong enough. I mean, the fact that it's in the camera, I understand they're ringing, you know, fighting their corner, but from the business perspective, why are we very concerned? I would support this application, such my proposal.
As a person who's passed it many times and seen it empty, I can't see that it's what a community asset.
So that's proposed by Councillor Lowe, seconded by Councillor Brooks. All those in favour? So no objection. And we have given careful consideration to camera and the other reports, but feel that the fact that the neighbours and the workable business plan are overwhelming sort of considerations to allow it to go ahead. Good, well done. Yeah, it was unanimous as well, yeah, thank you. Third one is front porch, 10 Hardwick Close. It's not just a front porch, even though it doesn't say it on here, but it's also, there's a garage conversion into a playroom, isn't there? So the location plan is there, as you can see. The actual footprint size is insignificantly changed. So when we go to the proposed plans, there's another picture somewhere. Oh no, sorry. Yeah, sorry, go back up. Right, the one on the left shows a garage door, left as I'm looking at it.
Yeah.
So that's a garage door, and then it's got a sort of a front door next to it. And then when you look at the one on the right, you can now see that there's windows in the garage door. And then you can see that there still appears to be a front door. But when you look at it, if you move the plans down now, we now see from the top, you see the garage on the left and the porchway or the doorway is set back. And when you look to the right now, you can see what we want to do. The porch is literally just bringing the front door forward to be in line with the front garage wall. And they're going to be turning the garage into a playroom. I cannot see any reason to object to this. There is nothing was in the planning online application. It's a lot of people, we said before, are turning garages into additional living space. Mm-hmm. Any other comments from the table? This is South East Ward, actually. This is one of yours.
I don't have any problem with it because it's got off-street parking. Mm-hmm.
Well, the windows that they're putting into the garage sort of appear to be look like they might match the rest of the house. Mm-hmm. And yes, it looks like it's got three car parking spaces at the front. Yeah. So, proposed by no objections. From Councillor Brooks, seconded by Paul. All those in favour? So that's no objections from the town council. It's a
modern house with garages and no good anyway for cars.
No, well, that's why you can't get car doors open. That's what the trouble with them, isn't it? The next one is change of use offices to dentist. This is on the northeast. This used to be Jules's, didn't it? Yeah, it's the change of use, and when you look at the plans on this one, that was it, wasn't it?
Oh yeah. Just checking on the thing.
Yeah, that's it. This is at the back of Rutland Radio, isn't it?
Oh right, I thought this was seen up in Canterbury. Well, I misread that. Yes.
Yeah, it is. It's
yeah, this used to be Jules.
Yeah.
And then it became sort of an optician's and all sorts of things, hasn't it?
Yeah, another business of some sort. So obviously there's another dentist coming into town. Well, with a growing population, there's a lot of teeth now chattering that need to be sorted.
I thought that Rutland County Council had sold it. That's what was confusing me.
Well, they probably have.
But it's got their name on the...
I think that there was a concern raised by one of the neighbours about the amount of parking available around there when people were visiting. But there is a paying display car park there.
They're the big one.
Yes.
And that's a lot of space.
That's long stay. Now, I don't know whether they have a, I don't think they have three half-hour fire or anything like that. But But the thing is, if people go to the dentist, I have to go to the dentist, and you either walk or you whatever. Anybody got any other observations or comments about it? It's the fact that it keeps changing hands and finding a use for it, so...
Yes, it's a funny building tucked out the way.
It is that, yeah. Anything from the table, the floor? No, councillors? Anybody want to make any proposals that we do or do not object? I personally don't have a problem.
No, it's just this acknowledging the objection to the parking space.
So town council got no objections to the change of use, but we would echo that parking does get a bit jammed at the back.
Yeah, and show respect for them.
Yes, good point, yeah. And dentists should make sure that not only their staff, but also their visiting
I'm sure they might look into what parking space.
Are you happy to be the proposer for that one, Nick?
Yes.
Seconded by Paul. All those in favour? So that's a go ahead. It's going to be an NHS dentist as well, isn't it?
Yeah, that's a letter from NHS.
Yeah.
So it's good. Alright, what's next? First floor side extension, 103 Braunston Road. This is number 5, I'm assuming this.
Yeah,
107. So Braunston Road. I was trying to think how far up Braunston Road is, but it's quite a way up, isn't it? Mm. There's been loads of work going on up Braunston Road with various bits and bobs. So that's the location on Braunston Road, but the location, the site plan just gives a... It's an odd... I didn't get the site plan. It looks like they've laid the building down on it. So if we go to the plans and location plan... Oh, that's right, yeah. You can actually see the befores and afters there. So the picture in the top left, existing, and then just below it proposed, it actually looks quite attractive. And then obviously the side angles there as well. And this is, what is this on? This is obviously going to be on the north, isn't it? But it's on mine, northwest. It is on mine, isn't it? I think I'm northwest, aren't I? And I say, there's been loads of work gone off on Braunston Road over the years, with various people extending. They've got the capacity to extend there, where it doesn't seem to impact on neighbours. So, yeah. I didn't think they were getting much out of it when I looked at it. But they are, they're getting an extra bedroom, aren't they? Because they're sort of moving up. Mm. Bedroom with an ensuite across the front of the house. Or wherever it's going. So, any other comments or observations?
There's no comments from neighbours.
No, when I looked through it, I've picked up nothing at all from neighbours. There've been no objections. Once again, there is no issue with parking in this area.
Same materials.
The planning application will be brick matching, same tile matching, and all the rest of it. So it will be in keeping with the property. And it's a London. These are all London brick houses up there, pretty much. So the bricks are quite available. Proposed, Nick, was that? Proposed by Nick, no objections. Seconded by Paul again, all those in favour? So that's unanimous as well then. I like the next one. The next one was quite... I was a bit amazed when this one came through. I've never known this before. This is number 6. This is the proposed temporary dwelling to accommodate worker. I think it's worker and family, by the way. Glebe Farm, Cold Oakton Road, so it's within our area. Mm. It's still on the northwest. And, I mean,
it's a common thing that comes up through Rutland.
Yes.
And they do tend to approve it at Rutland County Council. But,
when you actually look at the... so the site plan shows roughly where it's going to go, which I think is what that... what that little box is. But when you look at the actual layout of the building, showing the layout of a log cabin. That's it there. And this is why I think it's not just a worker, I think it's a worker and family, because it's got a couple of bedrooms in it. Mm. It is only a temporary structure. I believe that they can only be up for 3 years, legally. And reading the notes on the town council website, it says the application is there, because they have an external sort of examination done on this sort of thing. The application is therefore in line with the paragraph 55 of the National Planning Policy Framework 2012 and the criterion guidance with Appendix 1 of the Rutland County Council Site Allocations and Policies Development Plan document. So this is where isolated rural communities where they struggle to get workforce in, that it's not uncommon to have these buildings up. Normally, it would only be for 3 years. So if we have no objections, which I don't think we have got grounds for at the moment, and it also helps encourage bringing workforce in, that it would be that the county council do keep an eye on it. You know, we don't want to be turning into a I mean, it could really
it's quiet. The thing that they have to deal with, that they've had a few out in village areas where they've had issues, but that's not an issue now.
Yeah.
At the moment it's just temporary and
yeah.
I don't see a problem.
No, okay. So basically town council, no objections, obviously because it meets the technical, it's under the technical agricultural appraisal that sort of signed it off to me. I'll propose that then, so there's no objection. Seconded by Martin, thank you Martin. All those in favour? That's unanimous as well then. Right, now we get down to it, don't we? Trees. The first tree is 4 Dawson Court. This is on the northeast. That's not it. That is South Lufton.
Right.
I know. That also says 4 Belfield South Platinum. Let's just unplug your thing a minute. I wrote to Rutland County Council and pointed this out to them that it was an error. And they've corrected it now on the website, but they told me that you would have been notified, but obviously not. That up there is the actual, this is the location. This is all that is on the
application.
On the application. It's obviously got that, the front page, and that's just my guidance notes. So when you actually go into it, this is the diagram. Now the long white building, I believe that's the ambulance garage, yes? And then Dawson Court, so number 4 there, because it says the T1, which is that tree, cherry tree is T1, cherry tree fell, take it down, due to excessive shading, so it's right at the bottom of their garden, and it's to prevent future damage to the neighbour's garage. Well, the only garage it can be is the ambulance garage. But without any photos of the tree, I wasn't convinced.
And it's a shame Joyce wasn't able to do a report because I don't like the idea of felling a tree just on the description they've given there.
Well, I have reservations, like you just mentioned there, that excessive shading. Mm. I mean, it is. So look, so.
Even from that plan, it looks like it's down the bottom of the garden, doesn't
yeah.
it? So it's not really.
Right. So material planning considerations down there. Overshadowing, loss of outlook, to the detrimental of residential amenity. It's not a loss of you. It's definitely. So they haven't used the right terminology. It's excessive shading. So that's what they're saying, is it makes the house too dark. There's one of them later on as well like that. But then again, whereas I've already pointed out it's at the bottom end of the garden, these gardens are not very long.
No.
So, and of course, we remember the issues we had with the cherry tree on Royce's,
yeah.
where that was not even in the person's garden, and they said it was too big.
If it's that tree,
yes, it probably is.
It's this big.
Then you'll see it's a massive.
Oh, no. No, he said it.
We
don't
have enough information.
Oh, I've lost you now. Hit me, baby. Oh, just pass a little bit. Right, no, the tree is going to be here.
Well, then there isn't a tree.
There's no tree, because that's Dawson Court there.
That's,
that's a huge tree. That's in another applicant's garden, that is. So I don't see that it's an issue. So I have reservations whether this is.
I think the council.
Could we ask for further. Yeah, just ask for them to provide better information.
I think we should have a photograph and things like that.
Yeah. I would say the town council can't make a decision because there's no images of the tree.
Yeah.
And also, what distance is it from the property?
And has it grown too big that it can't be pruned? Because cherry trees are pruned.
Yeah. And I don't see what damage, is there any evidence of structural damage to the garage? No. So at the moment, the town council cannot make a decision based on poor information, no photographs, no measurements to the house, and it's questionable whether it is overshadowing the house. So the town council at the moment do not support this application due to lack of information. Is that acceptable?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Shall I propose that by the Lowe and seconded by Councillor Brooks? All those in favour? It's unanimous. Do you want to stay on while I'm here? This one in, next one then, what's it say on the list here? Cherry tree, no, we've done the cherry tree, that's fine. This is the mulberry tree, oh, this is the crown lift, isn't it? Proposal, one number mulberry tree, crowned lift to 2 metres below the canopy to remove downward, yeah. And then it said, yeah, that's pretty much what it is. So this is the on Northcote Street, that's the pencil outline of it. And it states here, notice of intention to carry out works to tree in conservation areas. So that's very clear, it's a nice diagram actually. And then I believe this shows a nice diagram of the thing, but the thing, all they're doing is they're lifting it. They're not taking it out. Yeah?
No, I think this one's okay. I think Joyce would say it. Yes. I can't speak for her. But
when you look into their detail that they put, the Richard Mews, they've stated that the fruit falling from a mulberry tree is a nuisance and a potential danger to users of the Mews getting struck by whatever it is, a mulberry.
Is that fruit?
So the proposal is to carry out lifting, lift the crown. That just means where it's all big and bushy, take out some of the low branches. So that seems reasonable. So based on the fact that it's a good application, then the owner is giving due consideration to his neighbours. Proposed by Paul, seconded by Nick, all those in favour?
Yeah.
So that happy with that?
Probably good for the tree itself as well.
Yes, yeah. We'll get that fruit flowing. Probably. So we're up to number 8. That should be 1X, shouldn't it? 5, 6, 7, that's 8, it should be 1X.
Never mind. I
have to
do this agenda,
so No,
that's
right,
it's
fine. Let's go back there.
I did it.
Right.
That's
it.
Oh no.
That's at home.
This is Mr. Davis. This is in the southeast bungalow. Have you aware of this one, Mike? Have you been down and look?
I tend not to go to the good. Normally we have our tree warm.
But we're not meant to go anyway, obviously.
No, well you can, but you have to ask permission.
Absolutely, yeah. It's the bungalow on Uppingham Road. Basically, it's on Mount Pleasant. So this shows Uppingham Road, which is the line running from the 12 o'clock position to the 6 o'clock position. Shows the boundary line, which is the large square. And then it shows number 1, which is the property. And then it's got a G1, a T1 and a T2.
I do know which one it is.
Well, it's... By looking at it, it's so there's T1 and T2. When you look at how close they are to the property,
yes,
and they have to put it fell. So both of these chaps, they want to take them out because of the close proximity to the dwelling. We can't say overshadowing because look how high the canopy is. But they are very close to the property, and then they also want to fell one number maple tree because it's that's T1 looking at it from the front, and that's T2 with a bit of fungi. Looking at it from the front, you can see G1, which is the big bushy tree, and when you look at it from the side angle, you can see it's set between the wall and another row of Scots pines. So that it's a felling of 3 trees. Anybody got any, having looked at those pictures, would you want?
I have a slight issue with some of the trees coming down in that area, because there has been trees close by there coming down in pastures. So obviously number 2, I'm not an expert on that fungus, but if it's diseased, then I can't object to that, but the other trees have been there a very long time.
Indeed.
And not been an issue, so I have no objection to the crowning and things, but...
Well, this is 3 removals completely.
But
if it was my property, I would consider them a hindrance, and I don't think they benefit the area looking at aesthetically they aren't recognised.
Right, and that's interesting because on the there is a thing about sort of in here about how trees make an area loss of effect on trees, and to a certain extent...
When you drive up that road, that's when, if you're next to that bungalow, that's dreadful,
yeah,
the sight of it, but when you actually drive up Stamford Road, those trees all do act and hide what's all the houses there, that's the problem. And they've been allowed over the years to grow, and they, but
it's peculiar shape for it, that's a palm tree.
Well, those three long ones, yeah, well, what it is, I would say that they probably crowned it as it's gone up. And,
and I think that, if I remember right, I think there probably were other trees near those at some point. That's probably a lot of it's been overplanted at times.
Well, I think given close, I mean, I can understand the anxiety of the applicant if they're that close to their property. And also, I think there was a, where you've got pine leaves, or pine, whatever they're called, onto the roof and into the gutter. And the fungus is a consideration, but once again, I'm not an expert. But certainly the mulberry one, I haven't got an issue with that, because it's between the wall and the those other three. And it can't be good for that tree there. At least they're not getting rid of those other three. So
does it give a date?
Pine trees, you know, fairly shallow rooted things, so a strong wind
could have,
none of them have fallen down yet.
It just says the applicant, it was registered on the 22nd of November 2017. It's in the consultation progress. I've seen no complaints or rejections online.
Does it say what time it's closing this one? Because it could be that we defer it.
It's only 21 days.
27th of November, it's 21 days.
So Joyce wouldn't be back in time.
No.
We need to make a comment that maybe the tree people knew, because we didn't have our expert.
I would say that
the Rutland County Council take, you know, proper care of it.
Well, the thing is, they put a picture of this fungi up there, but there's no report by any tree expert. So they the owner hasn't probably got tree.
Because you can get tree fungus that doesn't actually harm the tree. I don't know what that is, but Joyce would have been able to tell us straight away.
I think also that mulberry tree, when you look at how it wraps around that telephone pole. So are we objecting? I don't feel I've got strong enough grounds personally to object.
No, I don't think we object, but if we could, because we could say that we don't have enough knowledge to make a decision on these.
So we have no significant objection.
Could the tree, what do they call the person at the planning of the tree, the arborologist? The Rutland County Council's tree person take a closer look.
Yeah, brilliant. So the Town Council have got no objections based on what the application currently states. However, if the as long as the County Council's equivalent to their tree warden gets an eye over it, but apart from that, Town Council have got no objections. So propose those comments. I'll let Martin, you can propose them, because you basically made most of those. And seconded by Nick. I've got it. And all those in favour? Unanimous.
Soon we're missing Joyce.
A minute that. Oakham South East. 23 Stamford Road, proposal. Two yew trees and one whole oak. Prune back, overhang over garage. What's it say? It was just pruning and prune over the drive. So this is more the control I've got. This is a pencil diagram of it, which is once again not bad. Stamford Road, as we know, is like tree heaven, isn't it? It's beautiful. But when you see how close they are to the drive, there are other trees adjacent the drive, but without any branches low enough to require pruning. So this is once again, they're just trying to raise it up and relieve some of the tension.
The trouble is, if I've learned from a tree in my garden, the more you do that, the lower down, the higher they go.
Absolutely, yeah.
But there is something special about Stamford Road, so I'm pleased they're not burning.
And the reason I want to do this is to let more light into the house. So based on that planning application, I would propose that we support the application. Yeah. So Town Council, no objections, supported because it's just pruning. Proposed by Councillor Lowe, seconded by Paul. And all those in favour, unanimous. So, and then one more. There's one more. This is on the North East Ward, T-Ways, 95 Station Road, Oakham. This is an outgrown poorly formed trees of low amenity value. But the tree doesn't feel that way. It's fell to make way for new landscaping design. I like this one only for the fact that it was probably one of the more genuine excuses, I think. Which one is it? It's T1 proposal. G1, T1 and T2. Basically got three trees there that they... poorly formed. I don't think there's any photos of this, was there? No.
No, there's
no. Right, there's no photos. Once again, it's disappointing.
Was this? Is this that one?
Yes, I know, but that's, it says deformed tree. You know, nice to see a tree with a swing lights on. So please identify the trees and provide... So there's a thing there where it says what they expected to do. And all the person put in response is that little bit in the box at the bottom. Mm. Outgrown and poorly formed trees of low amenity value failed to make way for new landscaping design. So at the end of the day, I think the poorly formed is more to do with they just want to landscape their garden. And I don't feel that is a justification to do it. Are all three trees poorly deformed? I don't know. I haven't been down and had a look, and there was no photos. So once again, there's not enough information in there. This came through on the 21st of November. So once again, there'd be 21 days. I mean, I think the County Council may well pass it through, but I would say that I think I'm tending to lean towards, even though there's honesty in this one, they want to landscape. I would tend to reject it. That's my thought, but I'll leave it over to you guys.
I'll get second rejection.
So our proposal from Councillor Lowe, it's rejected based on poor information. We can't make an informed decision because there's no picture of the deformed trees. And that landscaping can be done where it incorporates trees.
Yeah.
And under the planning consideration, which is loss or effect on trees, we're losing the trees, which actually add to the environment here. So they want to take them out to make their back garden look nice, whereas other people do feel that trees in the in the built area are better placed.
Can I, Chairman, make a little correction?
Shoot.
You're saying deformed, it says poorly formed.
Oh, poorly formed, yeah. Right, okay, poorly formed. Poorly formed will do right, okay, fair enough. So. But anyway, rejected it because there's no picture, we can't make the informed decision, and on grounds just to do landscaping, it's not, we feel, a good enough reason. So, proposed by Lowe, seconded by Martin. Yeah. All those in favour? That's unanimous as well. Is there any other bits that we need to go?
No.
Is that something else? We don't have any other business, so at whatever time it is, it's, well, I'll use the clock because I've got it in the number.
1839.
Yeah.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you very much, everybody.
Thank you.